वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल द चिल्ड्रन हु हैव जॉइंड. बेटा, वी आर गोइंग टू रिवाइज द लैंडस्केप ऑफ द सोल बाय नथाली ट्रूब्रोए. एंड इन दिस चैप्टर, बेसिकली दिस चैप्टर इज द कॉन्ट्रास्ट, फाइन, कॉन्ट्रास्ट बिटवीन टू कॉन्सेप्ट्स, फाइन. वट इज चाइनीज कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ पेंटिंग, सेकेंड इज वेस्टर्न कॉन्सेप्ट और मॉडर्न कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ painting, fine. The viewpoint of Chinese is directly different from the Western painting. So how they will be telling us the difference? By narrating some stories, and those stories are actually fictions. They are not real, but based on fiction is imaginary tales which are not true, but these are made to make a point clear to us. Okay, so ye fiction ki jo stories hain actually are telling us the concept that how Chinese paintings are, and the stories related to Western paintings will convey what is the concentration of modern concept of painting. Clear? In China, ये तो stories लिखी है मैंने hint के लिए दो, ठीक है? In China they believe in, you know, they borrow the mind of the onlooker. Wu Daozi was asked by Emperor Zhuangzong. This is the first story. Then Eye of Dragon is the second story. I'll be narrating the stories in detail. Clear? The basic difference between Chinese painting and Western painting is Western painting projects actual view of painting. Whatever is there in the painting, it believes in projecting exactly the thing it is. Fine? But the Chinese concept is different. Fine? That it will not project the actual view. It will borrow your mind. It will tell you where to look at in the painting. The painter will teach you, this is what I have made and how to perceive it also. But in modern painting, perception is up to you, how you perceive it. The basic difference is that. Is it clear? Fine. My concentration is basically on the MCQs of this chapter and main points, beta, kindly note down. Those who are attending to the class, kindly send me your feedback. Jaldi se. Diya is there. She is visible always. Aapko zarurat nahi hai beta. Video on hai aapka. Anjali, Raman, Aditi, Devur, Ishnur. Ishnur beta, sorry for after 9, we cannot open the link. ठीक है, इतना देर तक हमने लिंक ओपन रखा, फिर क्लोज हुआ, देन अगेन यू पीपल रिक्वेस्टेड कि मैम वी हैव ट्यूशंस, एवरीबॉडी इज हैविंग ट्यूशन एट डिफरेंट टाइम. अब रात के 9 बजे तक ट्यूशन हो, दैट आई कैन नॉट इवन डाइजेस्ट. फाइन, आपको 7 o'clock तक का टाइम दिया गया था कि दोज हु हैव, चलो है कि चलो 5 to 7 के बीच में. आफ्टर दैट ऑल्सो यू रिक्वेस्टेड वी एक्सटेंडेड, बट एट 9 or 10 or 11 वी कैन नॉट ओपन द लिंक फॉर द टेस्ट. एंड वी आर रियली सॉरी फॉर दैट. ओके, तो नेक्स्ट टाइम से जब 5 बजे है तब कर लो, 6 बजे है, कोई कोई ना कोई टाइम तो मिलेगा ही आपको. कॉन्टिन्यूसली थोड़ी 5 to 9 आप पेशेंट्स पे बैठे हो. काइंडली टेस्ट आर मेड फॉर यू पीपल, अगर आप ही नहीं करोगे दैट विल बी योर लॉस. नाउ 8th century पेंटर वु डाओजी वाज आस्क्ड बाय एम्परर जुआंगजोंग. सो 8th century की बात है. दिस tale dates back to 8th century, fine. Wu Daozi was asked by Emperor Zhuangzong to paint a landscape because jo Emperor Zhuangzong tha, he wanted to decorate the palace wall. Okay? So he wanted that, you know, people used to believe in decorations with paintings and all. So he used to believe in painting of palace and all. So when he did that, the master hid his work behind a screen. So the person who made it, the story, it is like that only, the fiction. So he hid this work behind a screen and he thought only the emperor will be able to see it. When I will bring the emperor, I will tell him how to look at this painting. And then emperor was, called, and Wu Daozi asked him to look at the painting. So he admired the wonderful scene. What he had discovered in the painting, forests were there. Obviously, landscape mein kya kya hota hai? Mountains, waterfalls, clouds floating in the big sky, men on the hilly paths, birds flying in the sky. Fine. So painter asked the king respectfully to look in the cave at foot of the mountain. वो कहता look in this picture, you know. They used to borrow the mind of the onlooker in Chinese concept. कि मैं आपको बताता हूँ कहाँ पे देखना है. He says okay, look at this cave at the foot no at the foothill of this mountain. He said the spirit lived there, and painter clapped his hand. So when painter clapped his hands, the entrance of the cave opened. Fine. He said the spirit lived there, and the cave was very splendid from inside. He offered to show that, Majesty, I will show you the way. Let's go. The painter entered the cave, but when the painter entered the cave, the entrance closed behind him. Fine. He said, "Ki sir, I will be showing you the way." So when he entered, the moment he entered, cave entrance got closed. So emperor was outside. He was astonished. He was startled. He was amazed. Ki what is happening? ठीक है, ये एक fiction story है. ये believable नहीं है, but this is the fiction. Before he could move or speak a word, the painting was vanished from the wall. Not a single sign of the painter, the painting or wood ozi jo tha painter or any brush was left. The artist was never seen again, and that was considered his last painting. So this is one famous tale of China, that the painters were so engrossed in making the paintings that he got lost with the painting only. Fine. So actually he tried to borrow the mind of the emperor to where to look at. So this is the way aapko jo Nathalie Truv Roy hai jisne ye chapter likha hai, is trying to tell you the Chinese art. Now let's conclude. Chinese paintings or Chinese landscape especially, fine, they do not represent the actual view. They borrow the mind of the onlookers where to look at. This is very difficult concept actually. Then another Chinese story, beta. आपने board पे देखा था. I have written first tale, Zhuangzong, and that is done. Then another is Eye of the Dragon story. Second story start हो रही है. ध्यान से सुनना. Fine. Another famous Chinese story about a painter, that a Chinese painter was there and he would not draw the eye of a dragon. He painted a dragon into the painting, but he did not draw one eye of the dragon. And why did a question bhi tha shayad aapko kal, that why didn't he draw the eye of the dragon? He feared that it would fly out of the painting. He was scared. So that was his fear only. So that is another story. Usko dar tha ki if I will draw both eyes, he will fly. Such stories played an important part in China's traditional education. So China mein they believe to teach or preach moral values by telling tales only. Clear? Then after that they have mentioned two names. Underline or write down. आपके पास book है तो book में underline कर लो. Confucius and Zhuangzi. ये जो books है Confucius and Zhuangzi, they are the famous philosophers of China. Their books are full of such stories. Fine. They help the master to guide his disciple in the right direction. So these stories reveal the spirit in which art was considered. Fine. तो ये story से हमें पता लगता है कि what was the position of the art in the culture of China. बेटा आपको clear है सबको? Send me the feedback. This is a bit tricky. This chapter is, when you read it, you won't be able to understand otherwise. Clear? So next. In 15th century, now moving on next, in 15th century a skilled blacksmith named Quinton Metsys, ab ye story another story. Fine. In 15th century, see 8th century se ab hum aa gaye hain modern era mein. Fine. 15th century mein western concept of painting. Blacksmith, a skilled blacksmith named Quinton Metsys fell in love with a painter's daughter. So this Quinton Metsys, he was a blacksmith. Who's a blacksmith? I asked you last time also, the person who works with the iron works, who molds the iron and all. Very tedious job it is, but people do not consider it respectable. Hum logon ne ek bifurcation ki hui hai, that this is respectable, this is not. All jobs are equal. So that blacksmith, he named Quentin Metsys, he fell in love with a painter's daughter. Painter father never accepted this boy into such profession. He said, ki, I will never have such a son-in-law who is a blacksmith. So one day, Quentin went into painter's studio secretly. Which studio? Painting studio. So he painted. He had drawn. A painting was there. And on that painting, whatever painting they have not mentioned, ek painting bani hui thi, he drew a fly. Usne uske upar ek fly draw kar di. Who was drawing the fly over there? Yes. The boy. Fine. Quentin Metsys. You should know the name. So he painted with such a delicate realism that nobody can. Actual view of the fly was given. Painter entered, painter took it for a real one. He tried to hit it away. Painter ko laga meri painting pe sach pe fly baitha, but it was not so. Then he realized, he accepted Quentin as his worker, as his apprentice. Fine. Then Quentin married his beloved and he also became one of the famous painters of his time. Clear? So this is another story which tells us that in modern paintings, in Western paintings, actual view is given. He never asked where to look at, like China, Chinese painting. The above stories from China and Flanders illustrate what each form of art is trying to achieve. Fine? So in Europe, the aim is a perfect illusion likeness. So jo Europe countries hain, they want to create illusion. And by creating illusion, aapko aise illusion hota hai aankhon ka dhokha, that you start taking the things for real. Fine? The European style of paintings, they create illusions, but Chinese art is not so. In Asia, the stress is on the essence of inner life and spirit. Clear? Now, after that, they have mentioned Western painting reproduces the actual view. Fine. And the European painter wants the onlookers to look at the painting from a specific angle. Fine. That I have already discussed with you. Now, next concept of Shan Shui. Likh lo isko. Concept of Shan Shui. Underline this in your books. Shan Shui. Which literally means mountain water. This concept is called Shan Shui, which means mountain water. And this means landscape, actually. Together, these words, mountain water means landscape. The mountain is considered yang, Y-A-N-G, and water is yin. So the concept of yin yang is also mountain water. Fine. Ying is yin, Y-I-N, yin is water. And yang is mountain. So now they're going to discuss the notion of Taoism. In the beginning, Yu Daozi is the name, D-A-O. Fine, Taoism word wahan se bana. Daozi se Taoism ban gaya. Ism means philosophy. ISM, jaise hum kehte hain, spiritualism. Fine, in that way, ism, ISM. So Taoism, this concept, they're going to discuss now. Interaction of yin and yang is fundamental part of Taoism. Means interaction of mountain, water. There is a third essential element also. In yin and yang, in mountain and water, there is one more element, third element. That is called void, middle void. Void means empty. This is gap. Fine. And in that gap, interaction of yin and yang takes place. That gap is mandatory for the interaction of yin and yang. This is the concept of Taoism. Clear? So this can be compared with the yogic practice of pranayama. Breathe in, jaise hum aapko yoga san to pata hi hai. What do? We breathe in, we stop for seconds. That is void, emptiness. Then we exhale. Clear? So they are saying that this can be compared with the yogic practice of pranayama. Breathe in, retain, breathe out. Similarly, yin, then void, then yang. In that way they are saying. The suspension of breath is the void where meditation occurs. So middle void is very necessary for the presence of both the elements. Nothing can happen without it. Clear? उसी तरीके से वो क्या कहना चाह रहे हैं, द चाइनीज बिलीव दैट अनपेंटेड स्पेस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन चाइनीज लैंडस्केप. क्लियर? जिस जगह पे कोई पेंटिंग नहीं है, वेयर नथिंग इज पेंटेड, अ वॉइड इज क्रिएटेड, दैट वॉइड इज ऑल्सो इंपॉर्टेंट. दैट विल टेल द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ वॉट इज पेंटेड. क्लियर? अकॉर्डिंग टू चाइनीज लैंडस्केप. इज इट क्लियर इफ यू आर लिसनिंग? Everyone, beta, shall I move forward? Yes, Anjali, Khyati, Diya, Aditi. Boys are not there. Naman, Preet, Harman, Sahaj. Baki, but Ishnur has given the feedback. Vansh Kapoor is not given the feedback. He's not there. It means Vaibhav. Vansh is there. Where is Vaibhav? Vaibhav is still not there, जिसके लिए इतना लेक्चर सुनाया मैंने. So once you can convey to him, he is not there, he has just joined the meeting. This is clear to me. So man finds a fundamental, उसका absent ही लगेगा आज वाली attendance में भी. Vaibhav is absent today. He is not giving any feedback to me. Anna online is not okay. अटेंड करना है, फीडबैक देना है टीचर को, देन इट इज मैंडेटरी. आई यू नो वॉन्ट टू रिमूव सच स्टूडेंट्स इन द मीटिंग, नॉट इवन अटेंडिंग. फ्रेंच पेंटर, देन बेटा आफ्टर दिस कॉन्सेप्ट कम्स द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ आर्ट ब्रूट. Jodhpreet, any bit of doubt that you can type in the chat box, or by mistake you raised hand. If any doubt is there, you can type in the chat box, okay? So, art brute is the next concept. Okay, Jodhpreet, it's okay. Next concept is French painter Jean Dubuffet. He first created this concept of art brute or raw art in 1940s. Means art of untrained visionary. The person who is not at all trained into this, that is called brute, art brute, raw art, fine? The outsider art has gradually become the fastest growing area of interest in international modern art. And this is the work of those people who have no right to be artists. Okay, usko kehte hain art brute. Got it, dear? The people who do not know how to do paintings, they do not have rights to do paintings, when they create something, that is art brute. And they do not have received any formal training in painting. But they do have talent, they do show artistic insight. Aajkal bahut sare bacche social media pe, Instagram pe, Facebook pe, they share the creativity. But they are not trained from anywhere. You know? That they create such beautiful things, but they're not trained. That is the example of art group. That they're creating on their own. They're thinking, they're watching videos, they're learning. Even without watching videos, they can create something out of the waste also. Clear? So that is the example of art group or raw art. And it became famous in 1940. Fine. Then after that, they have mentioned the work of 80-year-old Nek Chand. Underline this, beta. रॉक गार्डन की बात होने लगी है. When Nek Chand, who created, who had the vision of creating rock garden when he was 80 years old, India's biggest contribution to outside art. He is the example of outside art or brute, art brute. He was not trained by any professional organization, He has made a garden sculpted with stone and recycled material. And it is known to the world today as the Rock Garden in Chandigarh. And recently released 50th scene of Raw Vision, a UK-based magazine pioneer in outsider art publication. UK walon ne, they featured Nek Chand and his Rock Garden sculpture as outsider art. Clear? His art has been recognized as an outstanding testimony. The Swiss Commission for UNESCO will be honoring him also. Fine? So by UNESCO, he was honored. Nek Chand says that walking through the garden and watching people enjoy the creation, when people love it, then I really enjoy it. Fine? So these are the different, beta, ek hi chapter mein, so many things are there. Fine? Chinese art, Western art, Taoism, raw art or art brut, yang and yin. So you should go through all the concepts. Chapter zyada nahi hai. But you have to read it with understanding. Let me share the screen. MCQs beta. Kal aapko 3-4 questions aaye the is chapter mein se. Fine. What two forms of art did the author contrast in this chapter? Ek minute, yahan pe screen gadbad kar rahi hai. There is some delay. I don't, if you are able to listen to me, stay there, beta. Beta, screen is visible to you, Diya? Yes? Nod your head. No? Okay, let me share again. An ancient art and Chinese art. Main dobara se share karti hu, abhi dekhna screen. Now is it visible? Send me the feedback, beta. अभी भी नहीं है. ओके, विजिबल है ये. ठीक है. फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट टू फॉर्म्स ऑफ आर्ट डिड द ऑथर कंट्रास्ट इन दिस चैप्टर. इंडियन एंशियंट आर्ट एंड चाइनीज आर्ट आपके सामने बेटा. यू कैन आंसर चाइनीज आर्ट एंड यूरोपियन आर्ट, अमेरिकन एंड यूरोपियन. ऑब्वियसली चाइनीज इज देयर, तो आपका सी और डी तो सीधा डिस्कार्ड हो जाता है जिसमें चाइनीज नहीं लिखा हुआ. अब बचता है चाइनीज आर्ट एंड यूरोपियन आर्ट, चाइनीज आर्ट और इंडियन एशियंट आर्ट. क्या आंसर है? चाइनीज एंड यूरोपियन. फाइन, दैट इज द करेक्ट आंसर. हु डिड द टैंग एम्परर जुआंगजोंग कमीशन टू डेकोरेट अ वॉल इन द पैलेस? यस, वेरी इजी. यस दिया,
एंड सी ऑप्शन.
Very good. C option, Wu Daozi is the answer. Fine. Next, who was the Chinese emperor during the 8th century? This is very easy. I want to ask Tang Emperor Zhuangzong. मैंने इसका full name नहीं लिखा था. You should know. Tang Emperor Zhuangzong. आपको भूल जाए ना, वो पीने वाला Tang होता है एक orange color का. Names are very difficult. Chinese name. So you can remember. Tang Emperor, they have written Tang, Yang, in that way you can get confused, okay? Where did the painter draw the attention in the painting? Sun, palace, birds, a cave at the foot of the mountain. Correct, aapka answer, Prabh has given answer is correct. Baki online students, only Diya is raising hand, what about others? Come on. Yes, Aditi.
Option D.
Yes, option D is the correct answer. Cave at the foot of the mountain. Next is what happened when the painter entered the cave? Bahut easy hai, entrance closed behind him. This is the answer. What happened when the painter clapped his hands? The painting on the wall was gone and so was the painter. Okay, let's discuss. Kyunki time kam reh gaya, I want to discuss more questions. Why did not the painter want to draw an eye of a dragon? Kal aapko aaya tha. He feared that dragon would fly out of the painting. What do the books of Confucius and Zhuangzi teach? To guide his disciple in the right direction, to not fear the superiors, to not suppress your thoughts. Option A. What was the name of the blacksmith in the 15th century? Yes, iska answer aap do mere ko. I won't tell you. Kitni baar maine use kiya tha. Diya knows the answer. What about others? Ishnu, Aditi has given already. Baki ke kaun se bacche hain? Khyati, you can answer this. Khyati. Manjot. यस बेटा बोलो आई अनम्यूट यू बेल हो चुकी है आंसर इज क्विंटन मेटसिस ओके सो यू कैन गो थ्रू एमसीक्यूज एंड बेटा सीबीएसई हैज ऑल्सो लॉन्च्ड लेटेस्ट सैंपल पेपर्स आई डोंट नो अबाउट प्लस वन बट 10th एंड प्लस टू इज ऑलरेडी आउट सो यू कैन चेक ऑन सीबीएसई ऑफिशियल वेबसाइट ओके फॉर योर रेफरेंस एंड कीप ऑन सॉल्विंग ऑल द सब्जेक्ट्स फाइन वट एवर फ्रॉम वेयर एवर यू गेट द मटीरियल फ्रॉम एमसीक्यू जितने करोगे उतना ही आपका बेनिफिट रहेगा चलिए आई एम गोइंग टू एंड द मीट हैव अ नाइस डे